Here's this GE clock. It's pretty cool. It looks digital, but it's not. It's got a regular, you know, motorized mechanism behind there, and it's a light. Just covers up, keeps the light from coming through there. It's about to change pretty soon, and you'll see it changes weird numbers because it has to. There you go. Yesterday it said it was, or this morning, well, technically yesterday morning now because it's midnight. It said that it was 10:90 in the morning when I looked at it. It was changing from 10:29 to 10:30. So yeah, it's just changes wacky numbers because I don't know how to describe it. It's just these weird little pegs that move back and forth, and so it has to switch between different numbers, and they're not in order. And so it does some bizarre stuff, and especially I wanted to get a video clip where it changed all the numbers. Well, not counting the one, but changed the hours and the minutes at the same time. So, yeah, just wanted to, there you go. Just wanted to share that with you. I just bought a whole bunch of clock radios on eBay, mainly just because I wanted this beauty here. But I really wanted to show you that, and yes, my desk severely needs cleaning because this thing takes up so much space, and I had some stuff stacked on the computer. I've had this one plugged in for going on, it's about 20 hours now, and it's been keeping time quite well, so I'm happy with that. Radio works on this one too. I thought it worked. There we go. Yeah, this one needs some help. This came unglued when I pulled the knobs off to take it apart. This is loose. And as you can see, this side of the display is pretty dim. It's because it's got a 12-volt bulb in there, and it's only a 6-volt rated thing. So I gotta get new bulbs for it, but everything seems to be functional, which is cool. And the snooze button, I think, is out of alignment, so I need to be careful next time I put it back together. This basically is just something that pushes down an actual lever inside there. I don't think it's lined up, but the radio works. It doesn't sound the greatest, but it sounds better than, you know, most clock radios, but it's not the greatest sounding radio. But, this thing here has an awesome radio. Ah, that one already changed. I had it set up so this one changed first, then this one, then this one, but I unplugged this one and plugged it into a different outlet. So they're off a little bit now. So these ones changed at almost the exact same time now. So, but yeah, I just wanted to show you mainly this clock because it's very interesting the way it works. And I'm gonna pull it back apart when I get the bulbs, and I'll make a video of the inner workings of this clock because it's really cool. Because it looks digital, but it's not, which is very interesting. And I don't have a whole lot more to say, but that's the alarm indicator. But, yeah, it has a dimmer on here. That's low, or that's medium, that's high. And low seems to be off, so I don't know if it's a bad resistor or if it's actually supposed to be off, but there's two resistors attached to that switch, so I imagine it's supposed to be off. But this video's got to be going around 5 minutes. I only know because I'm making a video of a clock. But I'll catch you later, guys.